Alrighty, hello guys, welcome your faces back to another Stormworks build and rescue video. Today we've got the Zephyr-Class Hovercraft, and this was built by White Noise, and we're going to be using it today to actually do a mission, maybe. I don't know whether we've got any missions. Yeah, we do. A boat without an exact location. What the? It's a million miles away. We probably won't be doing that mission. But anyway, we're going to test this thing out by actually getting inside of it, starting it up, driving it down to the beach, and moving it around in the water. We might also mess around with some waves and stuff like that, and I guess we'll see what happens from there. But this thing was built by White Noise, so obviously it's amazing, and yeah. Anyway, let's go ahead and get on with testing it. We'll move it outside. We might even put something on the deck, like a little, I don't know, a little car or something, and we'll see how it handles that, and yeah, we'll see what happens. Alright, so let's go ahead and get inside. There is a quick little startup procedure thingamabobby written down on the workshop. It actually says, connect any of the batteries panel to the main line. Alright, let me get inside. Hold on, where's the batteries panel? Where is the batteries panel? Here it is. Alright, cool. So, here we go. Let's just turn all of them on, and that makes sense. Alright, very nice. Hover gen slash engine. Okay, good. Propulsion engine. There we go. All right, very nice. Power panel. Okay, good. I think we're ready. We are ready. All right, this is for the lights. Anchor. All right, cool. Dive, tow. We don't really need those ones on. We don't need that one on either. So we'll leave that as it is. That's okay. And right here we've got, what is this? What is this? Just a camera? Just a camera. Okay, interesting. Very interesting. All right, let's get in the seat and get moving. Oh yeah, look at that, that's awesome. So now we're sliding along the floor, and it works. It actually works really well. It's really fast, actually. This is way faster than what I thought. Alright, so let's go ahead and slowly get down onto the beach, just so we don't break it at all. There we go, we are drifting slightly, which is not good. Okay, over a rock, over a bunch of rocks. I might have damaged something there, but let's just get into the water and see how it deals with that. There we go, we're floating. Look at that, we're actually floating on the water. That's crazy. That's actually really cool. Up and down is pressure. Can I put more pressure? Oh yeah, look at that, we actually went up a bit. That's kind of cool. Alright, off we go. So this mission is actually, how far away is that? 26 kilometers, that's too far. That is actually too far away, so let's just not do that. We'll mess around with this thing. We got a heater right there, let's go ahead and turn that on. And I think what we should do as well, what's this? These are flares? Oh, we got flares, nice. We got high beam lights, we got retract mast, we don't need to do that. Hover engine fire extinguisher and propeller. Oh, okay, okay, we're good. We're good, we're just gonna get outside and we're gonna have a little walk around. What's this? Light switch. All right, lights are on, good. We got a fire extinguisher right there. Let's go down and, let's go down here and go backwards. We got a med bay. All right, very nice. We got some Arctic gear. We've got a light switch right here. We got a heater right here. We got more gear. All right, very nice. This leads out onto the deck, and that's it. All right, cool. Let's go outside onto the deck. Close that up. What have we got? We got some cables. Presumably on this side we got hoses. Yeah. We got a ramp. Caution, needs to be deflated. Oh. It needs to be deflated to use the ramp. Oh, that makes sense. Right here we got our fuse box, interesting. Right here we've actually got our crane pivots. Here we go, like this. And like this. Alright, so we should, in theory, be able to lift things onto the hovercraft. Literally just by doing this. This is crazy. This is crazy. Oh, dude, this crane's actually really nice. This crane is really nice. There we go, look at that. We could turn the magnet on, turn it off. That's awesome. Alright, cool. Let's go ahead and bring it back. If we can. Bring it all the way back. Yes. Okay, we're going to go ahead and do this too. Yep. And we're going to do this as well to sort of store it. And there we go. Nice. Oh, dude, that thing is actually very easy to use. Back here we got ropes in case we need to rope things down onto the deck. If we go back this way, we've got our engines. And we're good. We've actually got an underwater welder, a normal welder. We got a light switch in there. But other than that, we're actually fine, which is great. Nice. That's actually pretty epic. Yeah. Alright, how about we actually go back to an island now? We ramp ourselves up onto the beach. We try and figure out these ramps. And, yeah, we'll go from there. Actually, bad weather too. Let's put some bad weather on. Okay, so we're going to start with 50%. And this is 50% wind only. And it actually seems to do... Alright, I don't think this thing's going to have a problem with the wind. But realistically, I don't actually know, so... We might have some troubles? I don't know. Is it just going to fly? See? I don't know. If we go over a big wave and we start flying, I guess that could be really bad. Alright, okay. So I got a little bit distracted there. Let's go ahead and turn ourselves around. Get ourselves over to the beach. And we'll put ourselves on the beach. Well, then actually, we'll lower down the thing. We'll get ourselves a little, like, car thing. And we'll load a car onto it, and then we'll bring it back out into the ocean and see how it deals with that. Because it might deal with it really well, it might not, we'll see. It's also a little bit laggy. It is a little bit laggy dealing with this. Anyway, here we go. We're getting to the beach. Go, oh, okay, okay. Oh, wow. It actually dealt with that really well. Really, really well. Okay, turn ourselves around. We're drifting it. We are drifting it, yes. Okay, stop drifting. Stop drifting. Lower it down. There we go. I think that's how we stop. We release the pressure a little bit. Okay, very nice. Very, very nice. Okay, awesome. Right, leave this here. We're going to open up this door. We're going to go outside. And we're going to lower these ramps down. How do I do that? Can I just press this button and it does it? I don't know how to do it. Hold on, hold on, hold on. Can I turn off those engines? We need to turn off this one. And this one. We'll just turn them both off for now. And I think that's fine. All right. Is it going down? It went down. Oh, nice. All right. This one should go down too. Yes, it does. That's pretty epic. All right. Let's go get ourselves a go-kart thing. And we'll load it up. All right. Here it is. This is the thing that we're going to be loading. This thing is obviously completely poopy. But we'll just put it on the deck. And it'll be a little bit of extra weight. So, yeah. Let's drive this thing over there. We'll tie it down. And then we'll go back into the water and we'll see what it's like with like higher waves and faster waves, better waves, stronger wind, I guess. Dude, that thing looks amazing. Also, color scheme matching. Heck yeah. All right, okay. It's actually time to load this thing up. If this thing can get up there, that'd be great. If not, we could probably use the crane to actually lift this thing onto the deck. So maybe we should do that anyway. I guess not. I don't know. We know how the crane works now, so I guess that'd be fine. But let's load ourselves up. Here we go. Yep, I don't really have any brakes, so we're just gonna have to, like, stop randomly like this. Alright, cool. Tie it down. Stop, 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 stop. Alright, just attach you onto there, that's fine. Alright, grab another one. Attach you down to there, that's fine as well. Alright, attach you sideways and stuff. Where's the thing? There it is. Alright, one more. We'll tie you down on this side. I think we need more ropes on this thing. Not gonna lie. I feel like we need some more ropes. But anyway, we've attached this. That's all good. Let's go ahead and push this button. It should fold back up. We'll do the same thing on this side. Push this button. It folds back up. And beautiful. All right, let's get out of here. Okay, engines going back on. Propulsion, hover. Let's go, go, go. All right, lift it up. Yeah, I don't think this thing is gonna impact it very much at all. But there we go. Should we just ramp it off the side? Let's just ramp it. Here we go. Bad idea, but whatever. Really bad idea. Here we go. Here we go. There we go. Nice. Oh, dude, this thing is amazing. Look at my little go-kart going mental. That is going crazy right now. Yeah. All right, but it actually deals with these waves really nicely. So what we should do is make the waves worse. There we go. Okay, awesome. Off we go. How fast does this thing go? 82? Dude, that is fast. It's going to slow down every time we crash into a wave. But it seems to actually deal with these waves completely fine. And also, it just flies and then lands itself properly. So, that's actually great. This thing's amazing. Okay, so one thing I am actually noticing is with full wind, this thing actually gets pushed around quite a bit. Obviously, because it's actually floating and it weighs not very much at all. So, it kind of makes sense. But anyway, we're tipping. We're tipping. All right, we sort of rescued it from tipping over. Full wind, bad idea, but it's fine. It's fine. Let's go ahead and turn it off and see how fast it goes without any wind. Because I don't know whether it goes any faster or not. I'm not sure. Here we go. I want to see its max speed if we can. Here we go. Turn the waves fully off. All right. Doesn't matter wind direction. Let's just go. Floor it. Here we go. 60, 70, 80, 91, 88, 87. Okay. It settles at around 87. That's awesome. That is actually super cool. Look at it. Look at it. This thing's amazing. Alright, cool. Well, I guess there's one last thing to try, and that is probably it against the tsunami. So let's just spawn in a tsunami, I guess. Here we go, spawn in a tsunami. And in order to actually make it a little bit more, I don't know, a little bit easier for this thing, we're actually going to untie this down. We're going to delete these, so just drop the ropes on the floor, that's fine. We're going to grab this rope, drop it on the floor. We're going to grab this rope, drop it on the floor. We're going to run to the back and do the same thing. Drop it on the floor, very nice. And then we're going to get the crane. Okay, here we go. Crane is going to go up. Crane is going to come down like this. We're going to winch it down. Turn it on, there we go. Very nice. Go ahead and winch up. Here we go, this crane is actually stronger than I thought it was going to be. And yeah, look at that, that's awesome. Chuck it over the side. Chuck it over the side, here we go. Look at this. The tsunami's behind us. That's okay. Nice. This is epic. Winch down a bit. Awesome. All right, so I guess we can actually just drop it. There we go. We need to get this thing back to relatively normal stance. So let's just do this. All right, do this. Here we go. Get it all level and stuff, and that's fine. And then we can do this. Bend it around. And back down to there. Okay, awesome. Get out. We need to go towards the... Oh, I don't know if that's the best way of doing it. I think we need to go towards it, or we need to ride it. One or the other. Let's go towards it. Look at that turning circle, though. On a dime. All right, let's go. Full speed ahead. Also, what do the flares look like? Illumination flare. How many does it fire? Just one. It just fires one. Interesting. What about the smoke? That's a horn. Does that just fire one as well? That just fires one. Interesting. Cool. Anyway, there's a tsunami. Here is, what we've got, and, we're ready, I think. Are we ready? I feel like we're just gonna fly off the top, but I don't know. Here we go. Oh, it's gonna struggle. It is gonna struggle like crazy. Because this thing doesn't float very well if it's not powered. So, yeah, at the moment, oh god. Oh god, now we're in the air. Now we're kind of flying. Kind of fly. Look at all the rope fly off. Oh my. Okay. Yeah, this is a bad. This is a big bad. Landed. Submerged. We're back up. Engines are on again. It survives. All right. It survives tsunamis. That's awesome. Dude, this thing's amazing. This thing is super cool. There's not very many hovercrafts that we've actually had in this game. And this is probably definitely one of the most useful. The most practical hovercraft I've seen in the game. And I really like it. I really do. But I guess I'm going to have to end this video here for now. Because there's not much else I can actually do with it. But I'm going to go ahead and say thank you guys very much for watching. I think we might end up using this thing again. And probably actually trying out some other stuff. Maybe a multiplayer. We can actually do missions. That'd be pretty cool. But I guess we'll have to see about that. Anyway, for right now, I'm going to go ahead and say thank you guys very much for watching. Hopefully you guys enjoyed the video, and I guess I'll see you guys in the next one. Goodbye.